The first part is I was talking about the ecosystem where there is a whole lot of initiatives which are already ongoing. Some of them are very, very innovative, and I'm saying that it is a common intent of the government, the regulatory bodies, fintechs, payment organizations and all. And yet we don't see the impact delivered on the ground. Where is the gap? Is it awareness? Is it implementation? Is it adoption? Where do you see there are challenges here?
My instinct is that it's the two A words, it's awareness and adoption. I think there is a lot of activity out there, a third A word, a lot of activity by, as you say, regulators, government, the third sector, the financial services sector itself, to try to address issues of exclusion, but it's not being taken up in the way that we would hope. And the president of the Financial Inclusion Commission is Sir Brian Pomeroy, who chaired the original Financial Inclusion Task Force. And at the end, and this was back in the early 2000s, his conclusion when he finished his work was that the issue was not so much one of supply, it was now one of demand. That certainly in terms of retail banking, as I said earlier, there had been lots of initiatives. There are now, the requirements for basic bank accounts, etc. The problem is that many people are not taking it up. So where we've got a lot of initiatives that are going on, one of the big challenges is about financial capability and confidence in financial services. So we have had, I think we're now on our third national strategy for financial capability. I was privileged to lead the first of those at the FSA, where I think we did actually achieve quite a lot at that stage. And then the Money Advice Service, now Money and Pension Service, have had versions of a national strategy. But really, the levels of financial capability in this country are shockingly low. Even now, we managed to get financial education onto the national curriculum, but only in secondary schools, and no resources are made available to schools to teach it. Teachers themselves don't feel that they have the confidence or the capability themselves to teach it. And therefore, we're left in a situation where, although it's on the curriculum, very few children get access to it. So we have to do something about financial education. We have to do something to improve people's financial capability and their financial resilience. And that is not to put the blame for financial exclusion on individuals and their own failures, but it is to say that if you're going to give people that resilience and help them through the next crisis, and there will be another one, then we need to make sure that they have those four key elements of resilience. That's savings, insurance, financial capability, and access to affordable credit.
Okay.